Today's video is another installment of my Luffy's Awakening series. I already have three parts out, and you can think of this one as a 3.5. There will be a part four, but I want to give my thoughts on Gear 5 now that it is actually canon in the manga. So, my theory was pretty close to what actually happened. I said there would be a Gear 5 Sun God, and it'd be based off Nika and all that stuff, and not to my surprise so much is we get Gear 5. It hasn't had any name besides Gear 5. It's not called Gear 5 Nika or Gear 5 Sun God. At this point, it's just called Gear 5, but we at least know it has to do with the Sun God. I mean, look at his hair. It looks like fire. One big similarity is the fact that I claim that Gear 5 would have to do with Luffy's spirit, or in other words, his heart. If you don't know, in Japanese, there's a word kokoro, which can mean both spirit and heart simultaneously. And what we see with Gear 5 in the manga is that it does have to do with his heartbeat.
Basically, Gear 3rd, Luffy breathes air into his bones. In Gear 4th, he blows air into his muscles. And with Gear 5th, he blows air into his soul. Makes complete and perfect sense, right? Maybe not in the physical sense, but when trying to explain spiritual concepts, the more I simplify, the more confusing it'll be. You might be wondering if the air and liquid in his body start to heat up and he catches on fire, could that potentially be harmful to Luffy? Well, no. Just look at this explanation from Oda as to why Diablo Jamba doesn't hurt Sanji. It has to do with the heat of his heart, and I don't think Oda's just joking here. He might actually be serious. Which is precisely why I put such an emphasis on Luffy's inner nature. If his heart can match the heat of fire, or even greater than that, then he will be safe and sound being a god of fire. After he has found equilibrium within his body, his arms, legs, and head will shrink down to normal proportions and envelop in flames.
But let's talk about the differences as well. In my theory, I put a heavy emphasis on elemental attributes. Specifically, if he's a sun god, he would have a lot of fire techniques. And interestingly enough, or I could say ironically, Luffy hasn't shown any fire attacks in this new Gear 5 based off of Nika, the sun god. Is my theory way off base, or is there still potential for my theory to be onto something? Well, that's what today's video is going to be about.
I keep mentioning that Luffy needs mastery of Haki for Gear 5. Devil Fruit Awakening is the part where Luffy gets in touch with the outer nature, but I don't think that's where Gear 5 ends. I believe Luffy needs to have a balance within himself before utilizing the power of the outer nature that he pulled into his body. Haki mastery is the part where Luffy gets in touch with his inner nature. I'll elaborate more during the intro of part 3 of this theory.
In the latest chapter, Kaido proclaims to Luffy that while he does have a super powerful devil fruit, that is not enough to become the king of the pirates. Truly what matters is Haki. And if you recall, in my theory, speculating what Luffy's Gear 5th could be, I put a heavy emphasis. I claim that it is crucial that Luffy masters Haki for him to get the true power of Gear 5th. In fact, let me show a quick clip.
In my Understanding Haki series, I talk about how I believe the colors of Haki correlate to the seven chakras. Each of the chakra has its own element associated with it. In addition, each color has its own frequency. Breathing is also a frequency. Every breath is either in or out. Each gear form involves breathing in some way, but Gear 5th will require Luffy's breath work to be perfect. So I believe each Gear 5th form Luffy takes will be him breathing at a frequency that resonates with his surrounding. As shown with the breath of all things through Zoro, the surroundings do have their own each individual breath. Thus, why Luffy's mastery of Haki is just as important as the Devil Fruit Awakening when it comes to attaining Gear 5th.
Perhaps Gear 5th in the manga will actually be closer to what I speculated if Luffy completes his Haki mastery. One notable thing about Gear 5th is the fact that it covers Luffy in white. The color white is notable because of my Understanding Haki theory. In that theory, I show why there are colors of Haki. each color giving a different elemental property. So perhaps Luffy being covered in white is actually showing that that is the base form of his Devil Fruit Awakening. Luffy in his white form is a canvas, and should he apply different colors of haki to his body, it would create different elemental forms, such as Sun God, or maybe even Moon God, and many more that you'll see in Luffy's Awakening Part 4. So that's about it. Not as detailed as my usual theory video, but I just wanted to put that out there for anybody wondering my take on Gear 5 in the manga in relation to my Gear 5 theories. And you know what? If Luffy adds color to his Gear 5, maybe the new form he creates will be considered Gear 6. This is actually something I talked about in my Luffy's Awakening in the secret ending. So I'm going to show that secret ending once again for those who may not have seen it. Funny enough, in that portion of the video, I say Oda might make Gear 5 goofy.
His hair's going from an afro to something resembling a flame on top of his head. However, I could totally see Oda's playful and goofy self keeping the afro all throughout the form. And you know what? That would actually make some sense given that the sun is a ball after all. You heard it here first, Sun God Nika has an afro. While Sun God will be constantly breathing in energy, aka chi, Luffy will take in one huge spiritual breath. This means that in order for Luffy to maintain this form, he will have to spiritually hold his breath. I emphasize the word spiritual because I don't want you to get confused into thinking Luffy will not breathe physical air in this form. However, metaphorically, it will resemble him holding his breath underwater. Unlike all of Luffy's other forms in which he seems to bulk up in terms of muscle, it would be both funny and genius if the form Luffy takes before becoming a moon god shares the same appearance as Water Luffy. Similar to how Luffy wanted to fill himself up with water before battle, he will fill his body up and store a vast amount of chi. Now obviously Luffy isn't meant to fight while looking like Water Luffy, but that is the outer nature entering his body before he matches it to his inner nature. While that chi is inside his body, it assimilates and becomes Luffy's own haki, and then he projects all of that stored up haki outside of his body. The haki would take on the appearance of steam before cooling down and taking the shape of a ball, thus creating the aura sphere that surrounds him.
And what we've seen is that Gear 5 is very, very goofy. So that's another thing my theory got close to predicting. But anyway, without further ado, let's look at that secret ending clip.
I try my best to hold back from introducing too many concepts. This is the secret ending, so I might as well talk about one of those things right now. Recall when I talked about how before entering Sun or Moon God, Luffy would take on an initial physical transformation. In Sun God's case, his limbs and head would expand far too large, and Moon God would look like Water Luffy at first. Well, what if those initial forms were actually what Gear 5 is solely meant to be? And it is actually just the God forms that are Gear 6. Now, this is an idea that really doesn't change much of the theory. It's a neat idea, but I didn't find it worth it to add that in at the cost of confusing the viewer. When I think about it, Gear 3rd and 4th also have an initial phase, Bone Balloon and Muscle Balloon, yet those aren't considered their own gears. Despite this, I won't completely dismiss the idea of an initial phase being its own gear for two reasons. One, it could be symbolic, and two, it could be both funny and compelling within the plot of the story. First off, it would be symbolic because Luffy is heavily associated with the numbers 5 and 6 in that specific order. This is because Go Mu can be read as 5-6. As a result, Gear 5 and 6 being integral to one another would be quite befitting. As for the plot, I can see Luffy learning Gear 5 around the same time that he's learning Awakening. This could have taken place before Luffy got to Onigashima. The initial intention of Gear 5 could have been in order to use alongside Gear 4. The biggest drawback of Gear 4 is running out of stamina, So I could see Luffy coming up with Gear 5 to gain back that stamina in order to re-enter Gear 4. He may very well use it in this manner to attempt to defeat Kaido. But even that may not be enough considering Kaido also has Awakening and is far more experienced. I think Oda would get a kick out of fans' reaction to seeing Gear 5 not be a transformation, as most anticipated. Not only that, it would be very compelling in terms of plot to see Luffy's strategy not be successful. It would be so intense that us the viewers would be on the edge of our seats and Luffy would start to get really desperate, going as far as to try and surpass his limits. And Kaido is the type of guy to give Luffy the time and space to do so because of his morbid curiosity. Unfortunately, he takes Gear 5 too far and takes in far too much chi from his surrounding, which would cause him to metaphorically inflate until he pops. Just when you think all hope is lost, that is when the ghost of Wano would find their way into Luffy's body and he becomes Neo Nightmare Luffy. As I've said earlier, it could be bittersweet for Luffy to defeat Kaido in this manner. Nobody would be more disappointed by Luffy not being able to defeat a Yonko with his own power than Luffy himself. Thus, he would eventually have to learn that he can't surpass his own limits by going backwards. Gear 4 isn't the answer. Instead of trying to utilize the power of nature to fuel his own power, he needs to become one with nature in order to utilize a power greater than himself. As a result, Luffy will learn that to prevent himself from overinflating with power, he needs to turn that extra energy into a brand new power that he would call Gear 6, a power beyond that of man and resembling gods.